While all life must perish, that which is immortal is bound to be reborn. But the Shaper had no hand in your creation. Did he, sweet sisters?
You're our observer?
I am Layton. I am here to assist you.
How exactly? An observer's talents won't be of much help in this fight.
Oh, I fight for the Order of the Ashen Blade, in my own way. My presence here is proof enough of my worth. You, on the other hand, are said to be unstable, unruly, and unwilling to follow orders.
Our fame precedes us.
Why do you taunt us?
Your shade is speaking. And to me, how quaint.
Somehow, your authority as an observer is not enough to silence her. What happened here?
A tear opened, clearly. Its cause is unknown. But it's the largest yet seen, and I do believe, getting larger still.
I doubt the Order will be able to hide this one from the masses.
And once it was open?
Many were corrupted. Others were possessed. They saw to the rest.
The Order did not foresee it this time.
That is why you were called. You and your two comrades.
Three chimeras. At least the Ashen Blade is sparing no effort now.
Well, two chimeras, and you.
So caustic. Where are the others?
Strangely, those two did not wish to wait for you. You should hurry. Find them, and help them. If you can. Don't scowl at me. I can offer powerful assistance, if you do well.
Then let us pray you remain safe.
Indeed. May the Torchbearer light your way.
May the Judge show you mercy.
And may the Shaper grant you fortune in this life. If that's what you can call it. The freight elevators will take you where you need to go.
Good.
Perhaps you will prove us all wrong. I will be watching.
you make fun of us. But what do you even know about our kind?
That the Order forges the Chimeras, much like your big sword. Let us hope you're not brittle or blunt.
We're not weapons. We're people.
I find that argument quite hard to sustain in your current predicament. Anyway, each Chimera is born of the union of two different souls. And each one develops their own abilities in a most peculiar way. I am truly eager to find out what the two of you can do.
This is your first time with us as our observer.
Indeed. I must have committed some horrible sin to deserve it. Oh, don't be so touchy. You'd better get used to my witty remarks anyway. Just as I'll have to accept that I'm stuck here with you.
To everyone their penance.
So we have the grumpy, the witty, and the wise. A well-assorted team indeed. I'm sure we'll get along just fine.
If you say so. We've dealt with other tears before, but none as massive as this.
Definitely not the doing of a few rampaging wraiths.
They're always ripping and gnawing at the veil from the other side. Relentlessly.
Indeed. But something else must have happened here. We must find out what it was.
Layton, tell us the truth. How can you survive the dangers of this city?
Oh, I rely on my cunning first and foremost. But I also have this pendant. It emits a sound that hides my aura from those that would prey upon it.
I can hear it, and I can't stand it.
I can hear your jingling as well, in spite of my corrupted blood.
I am so glad to hear it. It means that I have nothing to fear from the two of you. For the time being, at least.
still lingers here? Will I ever be able to silence them in my mind?
In the forest, playing beneath the big oak. That was really the last time I felt happy.
Freight elevators. Someone blocked them.
But that will stop the people escaping.
Exactly. They left on their precious ships and left the rest to die. That way, they'd made sure they'd escape.
So cruel. Letting others die so they could live.
And yet they all died anyway. more. I've got more. I'm just one. I'm not done.
Way to the bridge.
If it works.